Okay, monosaccharide, it is a smallest unit of carbohydrate, which include triose, tetrose, pentose, hexose, heptose, you all know. So these all are the monosaccharides. Then disaccharide, maltose, lactose, sucrose, these all are the disaccharides. Polysaccharide, starch, cellulose, hemicellulose. Polysaccharide also categorized in a two part, homopolysaccharide and heteropolysaccharides. So homopolysaccharide, starch, heteropolysaccharide, chitin. So these are the different examples of carbohydrate. You also know the metabolisms. A sum of anabolism and catabolism is known as a metabolism. Anabolism, that means to build up the large molecule from the smaller ones by the use of ATP. And catabolism, that means breakdown of large molecules with the help of enzymes and convert into simple forms and release the energy. So they are known as a catabolism. So dear students, you all know the digestion system. When we are eating the foods, the food containing starch, cellulose and carbohydrates, different kind of carbohydrates. When it is entered into digestive system, it breaks down and converted into simple form glucose. Once glucose is absorbed, intestine transferred through the blood in various cells and organelles, then this step is start, that is a glycolysis. You all know digestive system, but you are not knowing how glucose is moved from intestine to the various organs. And that is a blood system. Absorption takes place, whatever the digestive material occur in the intestine, that absorb. And finally, absorbed material is transferred through the blood circulatory system to each organ and each cell. Cell absorb glucose, but glucose is a large molecule. It cannot directly enter into the cell. And that's why cell membrane has a specific enzyme, that is a hexokinase. And it is a one type of transporter also. Sometimes we are known as a glucose transporter unit. Hexokinase is an enzyme which can bind with the glucose and convert into glucose 6-phosphate. So outside glucose, when it is enter into the cell, it is converted into glucose 6-phosphate. मतलब ये कि जैसे ही आपकी डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम ने आपने कुछ खाना खाया, डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम ने डाइजेस्ट किया, जो भी कार्बोहाइड्रेट है उसको सिंपल फॉर्म ग्लूकोज में कन्वर्ट किया और ग्लूकोज ब्लड कैपिलरी ब्लड से हर एक ऑर्गनल ऑर्गन और सेल को पहुंचाता है। अब सेल क्या करता है, उस ग्लूकोज को अंदर लेना पड़ेगा क्योंकि सेल को बहुत सारा काम करना है, तो एनर्जी ग्लूकोज में से मिलने वाली है। तो जैसे ही वो अंदर लेने की कोशिश करता है तो अंदर नहीं आता है, तो सेल मेम्ब्रेन के पास एक एंजाइम है हेक्सोकाइनेज। ये एंजाइम ट्रांसपोर्टर की भूमिका अदा करता है कि जैसे ही वो हेक्सोकाइनेज ग्लूकोज है तो वो एक्टिवेट हो जाता है और ग्लूकोज के साथ बाइंड कर लेता है एंड देन आफ्टर इट एंटर इनटू द सेल साइटोप्लाज्म। बट इसमें एक चेंज होता है, हेक्सोकाइनेज कैन नॉट वर्क विदाउट एटीपी, तो उसको एटीपी चाहिए, तो एटीपी सेल देगा। हेक्सोकाइनेज ऐसा कहता है कि मैं ग्लूकोज को लेके तो आ जाऊंगा पर मेरे को कुछ सपोर्ट तो दो, तो सेल बोलता है ठीक है मैं एटीपी आपको देता हूँ एनर्जी सोर्स, ताकि उससे आप क्या हो गया, उससे आप ग्लूकोज बड़ा मॉलिक्यूल एंटर कर सक ले आ सकते हो सेल के अंदर। हेक्सोकाइनेज एंड एटीपी दोनों यूज होते हैं, दोनों काम करते हैं। हेक्सोकाइनेज बाइंड विद द ग्लूकोज, एटीपी गिव्स द फॉस्फेट, एटीपी ब्रेकडाउन टेक्स प्लेस एंड फॉस्फेट मॉलिक्यूल इज रिलीज एंड फॉस्फेट मॉलिक्यूल इज अटैच्ड टू द सिक्स पोजीशन ऑफ द ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल, सिक्स कार्बन पोजीशन। तो ग्लूकोज नाउ कन्वर्ट इनटू ग्लूकोज 6-फॉस्फेट एंड एटीपी इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू एडीपी प्लस पीआई। दैट मींस हियर द कैटाबॉलिज्म टेक्स प्लेस, फर्स्ट रिएक्शंस ऑफ ग्लाइकोलाइसिस, glucose is converted into glucose 6 phosphate. So this is the first reaction. This is a just a hint. You all know how the glycolysis takes place in the cell. So today discuss about the glycolysis. Glycolysis, that is the reactions. It contains the almost 10 reactive pathway, which is occur in the cytoplasm of the cell. Then after fermentations, it is anaerobic fate of fermentations. Pyruvic acid is converted into alcohol or lactic acid. Glycolytic flux, metabolism of hexose other than the glucose. This is the overall pathway. You can see central metabolic pathway where either protein, either carbohydrate or either lipid, when enter into the cell, it categorizes. If carbohydrate, then glucose enter into glycolysis. If fatty acid or lipid, then it form pyruvic acid. Acetyl coenzyme is intermediate or link between glycolysis and TCA cycle. And then after, TCA cycle run in the mitochondria, and ultimately the FADH2, NADH2, NADH is formed, and that is enter into oxidative phosphorylation, that is ATC, and finally it forms the ATP. So any kind of material when we are eating, either protein, carbohydrate, lipid, then it is a breakdown, convert into simple forms, enter into the cell, and then it gives the energy. So this is a normal process. You can see glycolysis. Glycolysis, glucose convert into glucose 6 phosphate, then glucose 6 phosphate to fructose 6 phosphate, fructose 6 phosphate to fructose 1,6 biphosphate, and then goes on. And finally, 10 reaction is completed, then it forms 2 molecule of pyruvic acid. In this process, all whole process, 2 ATP is generated by substrate level phosphorylation, and 2 NADH is generated, which is a use in a mitochondria. If it is a use in mitochondria, then it forms ATP, 6 ATP. So overall, 8 ATP, net 8 ATP is synthesized. Before conversion of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, it consumes 2 ATP. So total 10 ATP forms, 2 ATP is used. So net ATP is 8. When the pyruvic acid is formed, then it may convert into anaerobic lactic acid formation. If it is a yeast, then it is a convert into alcohol fermentation. And if aerobic oxidation takes place, then TCA cycle, oxidative phosphorylation, ultimately CO2 is released, oxygen is used, 2 NADH also enter into oxidative phosphorylation, and finally it forms the ATP. So fate of the reactions of glucose, either it can form the lactic, either it form ethanol plus CO2, or 6CO2 plus 6H2. So ultimately, whatever the carbon is added, glucose has a 6 carbon. If it is a enter into the cell, then aerobic metabolism carry out the 6CO2 plus 6H2. If anaerobic, then it may convert into ethanol plus CO2 or lactate. So you can understand, when glucose is converted into pyruvic acid, while generating 2 ATP molecule, NAD plus are converted, 2 molecule of NADH is formed. The oxidizing power of NAD plus must be recycled. So here the overall pathway, glucose plus 2 NAD plus, 2 ADP plus 2 PI gives 2 NADH, 2 pyruvate molecule, 2 ATP, 2 H2O plus 4 H plus. So this is the overall reactions of glycolysis. 10 enzyme catalyze, we are categorized glycolysis in a 2 phase. 1 preparatory stage or preparatory phase, that is a 1 to 5 reaction, and second, that is a payoff stage. ऐसा कह सकते हैं कि glycolysis को हम दो part में divide करते हैं. एक जिसमें हम investment करते हैं तो उसको preparatory stage कहेंगे, जहां 2 ATP हम use करेंगे, और दूसरा जिससे हमको return मिल रहा है तो payoff stage 6 to 10, जिसमें हमको 4 ATP वापस मिलेगी. 2 ATP हमने डाला, 4 ATP मिल गई. मतलब क्या, अल्टीमेटली 2 ATP का बेनिफिट हो गया हमको. सो फर्स्ट रिएक्शन हेक्सोकाइनेज, सेकंड एंजाइम फॉस्फोग्लूको आइसोमरेज, थर्ड एंजाइम फॉस्फोफ्रुक्टोकाइनेज वेयर अनदर सेकंड ATP इज यूज्ड, देन फोर्थ इज अल्डोलेज एंड फिफ्थ ट्रायोज फॉस्फेट आइसोमरेज. दिस ऑल आर द एंजाइम्स व्हिच इज अ प्ले अ क्रूशियल रोल इन फर्स्ट प्रिपरेटरी फेज. So you can see first preparatory phase glucose with the help of Mg plus 2 hexokinase and ATP, it convert glucose 6-phosphate. It is a non-reversible or irreversible reaction. Glucose 6-phosphate now convert into fructose 6-phosphate. It is isomer of glucose. Fructose is isomer of glucose. So here isomerase enzyme is used, phosphoglucoisomerase, and it is a reversible reaction. Fructose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6-biphosphate with the help of phosphofructokinase. And here ATP is used. So first ATP and second ATP. Two ATPs invest. These enzymes is converted fructose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-biphosphate. Now fourth reaction, aldolase, takes place, reversible reaction, where it split the molecule. 6-carbon converted into 2-molecule 3-carbon. One is a glyceraldehyde phosphate and second one is a DHAP, dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Once it is a form, it can interconvert. So with the help of triose enzymes, triose isomerase enzyme, DHAP can convert into GAP and GAP can convert into DHAP. So cell need GAP, so DHA molecules convert into GAP. So 2 molecule of GAP is formed and the end of first step. Let's see the detail. You can see the structure of glucose, 6-carbon ring structure plus ATP, hexokinase, Mg plus 2. You can see over here at the 6-carbon, PO4-2 is attached. And ATP is breakdown, ADP is formed and hydrogen is released. So this is the first enzyme's reaction. Second step, phosphoglucoisomerase. Here you can see this first carbon is involved. Glucose 6-phosphate now converted into, you can see, fructose 6-phosphate. 1 carbon is converted into ketone group and finally it formed fructose 6-phosphate, and this fructose 6-phosphate is important for the next step. So next step, that is you can see glucose 6-phosphate, here ketone group is formed. As I already said, it is a ketone group. Fructose is a ketone molecule and glucose is aldehyde molecule. So with the help of isomerase enzyme, the glucose 6-phosphate converted into fructose 6-phosphate as a ketose sugar. Then third step, where the ATP is used, you can see fructose 6-phosphate plus ATP, phosphofructokinase and Mg plus 2 as a cofactor, and it is attached the again phosphate molecule to the first carbon, so it formed fructose 1,6-biphosphate. And now fourth step, aldolase enzyme is used, which cleaves the fructose 1,6-biphosphate into the 2 molecules 3-carbon 2 molecules, and it is formed glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, that is a GAP, and dihydroxyacetone phosphate, that is a DHAP. So you can see over here the aldolase enzyme act and convert this one product, that is a DHAP, and another product, that is a glyceraldehyde. That means aldolase enzymes break the 6-carbon molecule, ketone molecule, and convert into 1 ketone and 1 aldose triose sugar. And these 2 sugar interconvert into each other and finally it form DHAP, GAP. Only GAP continue along the glycolytic pathway. So DHAP is converted into GAP. So 2 GAP molecules is enter into further pathway. So this is about our first preparatory phase. You can see this GAP is enter into the reaction, and then after subsequent reaction is goes on. So pehle 5 step humne dekhe, usko hum kehte hain preparatory phase. Pehla step tha glucose convert into glucose 6-phosphate with the help of hexokinase plus Mg plus 2. Mg plus 2 is a cofactor. Mind well, it is a inorganic molecules. Then irreversible reaction, okay, and here the ATP is required. That's why ATP is a breakdown and convert into ADP plus PI, and PI is enter into the glucose 6-carbon position, so it is converted into glucose 6-phosphate. Second reaction, isomerase takes place, so glucose 6 phosphate convert into fructose 6 phosphate. Third reaction, where ATP is used, fructose 1,6 phosphate convert into fructose 1,6 biphosphate, where phosphofructokinase is used, and then Mg plus 2 as a cofactor. So ATP again used, so 2 ATP we consumes. Then fructose 1,6 biphosphate with the help of aldolase, it converted into triose sugar. Two molecule triose sugar is formed, one ketone, DHAP, and another is the aldehyde, that is the aldose sugar, triose aldose sugar. And then finally, the glyceraldehyde is a converted glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate convert from DHAP, and this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate two molecules enter into subsequent reaction of the glycolysis. Okay, second phase, payoff phase. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme is used, which is a high energy intermediate formations. Seventh number enzyme, phosphoglycerate kinase. First ATP is generated in these reactions. That's why that reaction is known as a substrate level phosphorylation. Phosphoglycerate mutase, another enzymes, 8 number. 9 number enolase, second energy high energy intermediate formations. And 10 number pyruvate kinase, where second ATP is generated. So one glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate when enter, 2 ATP is formed. So 2 molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is enter, it forms another 2. So total 4 ATP is generated by substrate level phosphorylation, and 2 ATP already we invested in preparatory phase. So ultimately net ATP generated is a 2 by substrate level phosphorylation. Direct ATP is generated only 2. So let's see first step, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase, high energy intermediate formation. You can see glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate plus NADP plus PI, and you can see here the dehydrogenase takes place, hydrogen molecule is released and phosphate molecule is attached, and you can see NADH is formed. It is a independent high energy reaction. Another, it is intermediate form, phosphoglycerate kinase. 1,3 biphosphoglycerate, which is a generated in first step, sixth step, that is a payoff first step, then enter into the, it is a converted into 3-phosphoglycerate, and this 3-phosphoglycerate where one phosphate molecule is released, and with the help of phosphoglycerate kinase and Mg plus 2, ATP is formed, because this phosphate is released, so ADP plus PI is attached and it is converted into ATP, and this forms 3-phosphoglycerate. Now next step, that is a, you can see 1,3 biphosphoglycerate, here the PGK reaction, phosphoglycerate kinase reactions like this, Mg plus 2 ADP, Mg plus 2 is a cofactor and ADP is a bind to this area, then it is a converted 3-phosphoglycerate. So these P molecules enter to this area and it forms Mg plus 2 ATP. Mg plus 2 is a main precursor for the ATP. So in this reaction, you can see GAP plus PI plus NADP, 1,3 biphosphoglycerate plus NADH. So plus 6.7 kilo energy plus reaction. Mind well, so energy is required, that energy is given by the cell only. 1,3 biphosphoglycerate is formed, 3-phosphoglycerate is a converted into 3-phosphoglycerate reactions, and ATP is formed. So total free energy, that is a minus 18.8 kilojoule per mole. So net reaction is GAP plus PI, NADP plus ADP gives 3 PGA plus NADH plus ATP. So ultimately the minus 12 kilojoule energy is generated. Eighth step, phosphoglycerate mutase. 3-phosphoglycerate is converted into 2-phosphate. The shifting of phosphate molecule, nothing else. 3 carbon se second carbon pe chala jayega, third carbon se second carbon pe chala gaya phosphate group, aur mutase enzyme se wo hoga. So 2-phosphoglycerate is formed. Then reaction mechanism of catalytic 3-phosphoglycerate are require enzymatic activity, and this enzymatic activity is the phospho inhibition of enzyme with catalytic amount of P32 labeled isotopes 2,3-DP. PG, yield, T32 labeled enzyme. So it is a confirm that the glycolysis influx oxygen transportation 2,3-BPG bind to deoxyhemoglobin and alter the oxygen affinity of hemoglobin. Erythrocytes synthesize and degrade 2,3-biphosphoglycerate by detour from the glycolytic path. So this is a main important. It may be asked in the question. You can see glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, 1,3-biphosphoglycerate, 3-phosphoglycerate, and 2-phosphoglycerate. And this is important. Biphosphoglycerate mutase convert into 2,3-biphosphoglycerate, and then after 3-phosphoglycerate is formed. So this enzyme is a very precursor, and you can see 2,3-biphosphoglycerate is a bind to deoxyhemoglobin and alter the oxygen affinity of hemoglobin. In the case of erythrocyte synthesize and degrade 2,3-biphosphoglycerate by detour from the glycolytic pathway. So, yaad rakhna, erythrocytes ke andar ye jo enzymes hoga, wo usko eliminate karega. Lower BPG in erythrocyte resulting from hexokinase deficiency result in increased hemoglobin oxygen affinity. So, you can see over here, normal erythrocytes, pyruvate kinase deficient, BPG, lower the affinity of oxygen. And hexokinase deficient, higher the oxygen efficiency binding. So it is important that erythrocytes is a glycolysis. Agar wo nahi karega to kaise kaam karega? Enolase, second high energy intermediate formation, dehydration reaction. You can see 2-phosphoglycerate, enolase with the help of it form phosphoenol pyruvate plus H2O. And then after last reaction, pyruvate kinase, second ATP generating, you can see the phosphate molecule is released from phosphoenol pyruvate and it forms ATP with the help of pyruvate kinase, and last product is formed, that is a pyruvate. So balance it, you can see 2 ATP expanded, 4 ATP produced, 2 from each of 3 carbon molecules, that is produced by the glucose. Net production, 2-phosphate bond is formed, so 2 ATP per glucose. Glycolysis total pathway omitting H plus, which is a bind with NAD plus, and 2 NADH is formed and 2 ATP is formed. This is the overall balance sheet of glycolysis. So here you understand glycolysis pathway. Glycolysis is important. In aerobic organism, pyruvate produced in glycolysis, which is oxidized in mitochondria via Krebs cycles, and CO2 is generated. NADH, which is produced, enter into mitochondria and produce ATP. So ultimately, total net ATP produced by the 1 glucose molecule in aerobic oxidation, that is a 36 in eukaryotic cell and 38 in prokaryotic